I want to know what I will get from an independent Scotland with regard to education, health service and pensions. I don't want the specifics, but I want you to be, I don't want you to tell me, John. Just vote yes and the power will be transferred. I need to know what's on offer for me, my children and my grandchildren.
To an extent, nobody can know the future. I mean, nobody knows. As I said before, you vote yes and the power goes back to Scotland and we elect the people to take these decisions, whichever party that is. One of the things I do resent about the television coverage is that almost everywhere you see it, the assumption is the arguments with the SNP and all the no-camp. The SNP are not the yes campaign. There's all kinds of people in the yes campaign who don't agree with the SNP and have got different views from them as well. And mine would probably be very different from Alex Salmond's, if I'm being honest. But what I can tell you is that what will happen if you vote no, if, in terms of pensions, for example, Gordon Brown is at the moment going around the country trying to frighten pensioners by saying what happened with independence, you'll lose the British state pension. So the British state pension is actually the least adequate and one of the worst in the whole of the European Union. And in fact, it's £60 a week less than it should be, because for 31 years under Labour and Tory governments, the link with earnings was broken. And the £60 we lost over that period has never been put back in. So it's still one of the worst pensions you can get anywhere. And this new pension that's coming in after 2016 is not any better either. You'll have to work till you're 68 before you get it. You'll have to make 35 years of national insurance contributions rather than 30 as it is at the moment. The second state pension, what a lot of people get in Scotland at the moment, will be abolished after 2016. And most tax experts say that the pensioners who retire after 2016 will be worse off than they would have been had they been treated under the old system. Now, that we know for certain. I could only say about what will happen in independent Scotland is that some people might think I've been critical of the Labour Party here tonight, which I have been. But I also think the only way the Labour Party can get back, rediscover itself and be reborn is in an independent Scotland. Once it breaks away from Westminster, it can rediscover its own roots and it can be the Labour Party it used to be. Once again, George Galloway used to say, every country needs a Labour Party. Britain doesn't have one. Scotland could have one. And it would be up to them. There's no doubt that we can afford decent pensions. There's no doubt that we can afford decent schools. There's no doubt. Scotland's a wealthy country. Yep. All this nonsense about we can't. Francis was absolutely right. You're too wee, you're too small. Look at Norway. Their sovereign wealth fund is $8,000 million. Where's our sovereign wealth fund under Britain? We don't have one. They've wasted it. 30 years of oil wasted, mostly in unemployment and in factory experiments that never worked. Scotland is the better chance for ordinary people in this country, and I hope they take it.